Dinosaurs. They dominated the Earth during the Triassic period, 243 to 233 million years ago. A huge catastrophe occurred approximately 252 million years ago during the pre-Triassic or Permian period. During the Permian period, the world consisted of a supercontinent. There was a hot and dry climate, but many plants and animals survived during this period until the largest mass catastrophe in Earth history occurred 252 million years ago. In present-day Russia, mega volcanoes erupted and magma flowed out over millions of years. When the magma ended, lava covered thousands of square miles of the supercontinent. Apart from the lava, a large amount of gas also rose to the surface. As a result, due to massive global warming, Permian ecosystems changed rapidly and 95% of living species became extinct. The 5% that survived were dinosaur morphs, the ancestors of dinosaurs, and various animal and plant species. These dinosaur ancestors were small reptiles that were extremely fast and very agile, quickly covering the New World during the early Triassic period. Paleontologists have found fossil footprints and handprints of tiny dinosaur morphs dating back a million years from megavolcano eruptions. Dinosaurs survived this catastrophic period with their extraordinary endurance and emerged in the late Triassic period, between 243 and 233 million years ago. After this period, they came to the fore in the multicontinental New World, that is, in the Jurassic period. Over the millions of years that followed, dinosaurs grew larger, more diverse, and dominated the world. Dinosaurs are mesotherm creatures with characteristics between warm-blooded and cold-blooded. About 1,000 species of non-avian dinosaurs have been documented so far, and there are about 11,000 species of birds that are the evolutionary successors of dinosaurs. So that means there are about twice the number of living mammal species. Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus was the largest known carnivorous dinosaur that was semi-aquatic and lived both on land and in water. It was found to have lived in what is now North Africa approximately 99 to 93.5 million years ago. The skull was 1.75 meters long and was long, low, and narrow, similar to that of a crocodile. Its body was 14 meters to 18 meters long, and its mass was 12 to 20 tons. Spinosaurus had higher bone density and therefore had better buoyancy. Its teeth were straight and tapered, and its nostrils were near the eyes rather than the tip of the nose. With these compatible features and findings, it was known to eat fish, and most scientists think it hunted both terrestrial and aquatic prey. Spinosaurus's distinctive neural spines, long extensions of the spine, were at least 1.65 meters long. This has been called the dinosaur's sail. Spinosaurus had a long, muscular neck that was curved in an S shape. Spinosaurus, known from Egyptian ruins, was described by German paleontologist Ernst Stromer in 1915. These ruins were destroyed in World War II. However, other remains were discovered in Algeria, Morocco, and Tunisia in the 1990s and 2000s. Acrocanthosaurus. Acrocanthosaurus is one of the largest carnivorous dinosaur species that existed in what is known as North America during the early Cretaceous period between 113 and 110 million years ago. Its largest length in the fossils recovered was 11 meters to 11.5 meters, and its weight was 4.4 to 6.6 tons. The most well-known feature of Acrocanthosaurus was the rows of long neural spines found in the neck, back, hip, and upper tail vertebrae, which could reach more than 2.5 times the height of the vertebrae. Acrocanthosaurus was bipedal. It had a long and heavy tail and was an extremely predatory species. This animal's brain was roughly S-shaped and had olfactory lobes that showed a developed sense of smell. Acrocanthosaurus was classified as a carcharodontosaurid theropod in 2004. This theropod is thought to have preyed on duck-billed dinosaurs and four-legged plant-eating sauropods. There are known fossil remains of Acrocanthosaurus from the USA states of Oklahoma, Texas, and Wyoming, and as far east as Maryland. Pterosaurs. Pterosaurs were the first reptiles that could fly, and the first vertebrates that could fly. Pterosaurs, close cousins of dinosaurs, first appeared during the Triassic period 215 million years ago and evolved over 150 million years. Pterosaurs varied in size, feeding on insects, fish, fruits, and small vertebrates. The largest species had wingspans of up to 10 meters to 11 meters, while the smallest species had wingspans of no less than 25 centimeters. These were the largest animals known to be able to fly. This species could have reached the height of a modern giraffe while standing. Due to their bone structure, they were estimated to be extremely light for their size. Its bones were hollow and filled with air, like those of birds. Bone walls were often as thin as paper. According to estimates, the weight of large species reached up to 250 kilograms. Pterosaurs generally had long necks and large eyes. Many had skulls filled with long, needle-like teeth. A distinctive feature of pterosaurs was the crest on their heads. It was originally thought that pterosaurs did not have crests, but it is now known that crests were common. Diplodocus. Diplodocus was a genus of sauropod dinosaur that lived in North America during the late Jurassic period, approximately 161 million to 146 million years ago. These were huge dinosaurs and fed on trees, ferns, and shrubs. These dinosaurs, which were up to 28 meters long and traveled in small herds, weighed 15 tons. Diplodocus, which had a light structure compared to its length, had a very long whip-like tail and had approximately 80 caudal vertebrae. The skull of this animal, which had four legs and a long neck, was quite small and light. Diplodocus has been studied extensively due to the large number of fossils found. Because of the large body size of sauropods and the length of their respiratory system, scientists have wondered how these dinosaurs breathed with their long necks. They presumably had an avian respiratory system that was more efficient than the mammalian and reptile systems, as their bones were seen to have air cavities that were thought to play a role in respiration, as in birds. How did dinosaurs become extinct? Chicxulub crater was formed approximately 66 million years ago when a large meteorite, approximately 10 kilometers in diameter, hit the Earth, a crater buried beneath the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico. Although its headquarters are offshore, it takes its name from the coastal community of Chicxulub Pueblo. The crater is estimated to be 200 kilometers in diameter and 20 kilometers deep. The crater was discovered by geophysicists Antonio Camargo and Glenn Penfield while exploring for oil in the late 1970s. The date of the impact coincides with the Cretaceous-Paleogene boundary. The impact resulted in destruction and climate disruption. 75% of the world's plant and animal species have become extinct. This extinction included all non-avian dinosaurs. It is widely accepted that this event caused the extinction of non-avian dinosaurs.